it's a special one because it's our first one after 18 months of no in-person concerts.
Woo!
So, each composer, which we forgot to mention in planning, you guys can give a little something about the piece that you're going to be performing or have performed, just to give us a little flavor of what it's going to be like. And yeah, let's get this thing going. Cool.
Thank you.
synthesizing these strong beats. So that pattern is in 7. So it's a little different than just, okay, play this. Because suddenly we have to count 1, 2, 3. That extra little skip is kind of difficult. So this is focusing on that. I hope you enjoy it. Here we go.
which means I carry Kristen's around. So, because of that, I decided I'd pay homage to the people who in the past have been burned for doing things that I do today. So, I wrote this piece. It's very cool. It's very spooky. I know this isn't the one that's close to Halloween, but who cares? So, yeah, this is The Witching Hour. Oh, and I want to give a big thanks to Emma. I wrote this up like the last second, and she really pulled it together. She's an amazing bassoonist, as you guys are about to hear. So, thank you.
guys are awesome.
You're awesome.
Don. that I had the muster for it, you know? Because songs to me were like the most complicated creatures, like a combination of lyrics, poetry, things in motion, and a sharing of the spotlight. Until I had a great fascination with a sort of minimalistic approach to storytelling, minimalistic approach to songwriting, and then I started writing songs like this. Just gonna be me, my good friend, Chris, I mean Ben Rosfeld, as he is in your pamphlet.
This man's not me.
It's a wardrobe change. Yeah. So this is a breakup song, but not just any breakup song. It's meant to be haunting, like a weapon. Something that you're saying, like, I put a curse on you because you wronged me. And so I'm not going to make direct eye contact with any of my friends. No, that was a joke. All right.
Thank you.
group for just a second. I've been listening to a lot of Japanese composers lately for like anime and like film, if that makes sense. And so I feel like there's a lot of heavy influence for that in this piece. And I just wanted something kind of simple, something sweet. While you're listening to the piece, think about like a piece of candy or like a sucker. It tastes good for a second and then it's gone. So this is my piece, Wonder.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.